Hello everyone, welcome back to the course of Mechatronics. This is M.A. Jadhav and we are dealing with the A-to-D converters and D-to-A converters. We have already gone through analog to digital converters. In that, we have seen how analog signal is converted to digital form and different types of A-to-D converters. In this video, we will go through D-to-A converters, that is digital to analog conversion process. Okay, so let's start. Sorry for the interruption. The contents of this slide are, or rather video are, what is a DAC, types of DAC, binary weighted register DAC, R2R ladder DAC, and specification of DACs. In this particular content, we will be going through what is a DAC, different types, and we will go through binary weighted register DAC in details. So, what is a DAC? So, a digital to analog converter, that is DAC, converts a digital signal to an analog voltage or a current output. So, obviously, we have already gone through the types of these two signals, that is digital signal and analog signal. So, digital signal is a discrete form of signal and analog is continuous with time. So, we have seen that we need to convert an analog continuous signal to digital form for the processing. And again, in real life, the signals which are coming out of a processor are again analog signals. So, we need to give an analog output for the working of a mechatronic system. So, we need to convert the signal again from digital to analog form. So, here it is shown one digital signal in terms of a binary digital code is given to a D2A converter. And that D2A converter converts that signal again into a continuous form. This is a sine wave form is given here, which will be a continuous voltage or current output. It may be a voltage signal or a current signal. And this DAC must be provided with reference voltage for conversion. So, this is the procedure of a D2A converter. So, simply it will convert a digital value in again a continuous signal with help of some reference voltage. So, how it is done, that we'll be seeing through when we are going to go through the types of DACs. Okay, there are many types of DACs available. Usually, what we use in a DAC is different switches, number of resistors, and optional amplifiers are used to implement the digital to analog conversion. Basically, we will be going through the two different types of D2A converters. One is binary weighted register D2A converter and second is R2R ladder DAC. In this video, we will be going through details of binary weighted register D2A converter. So, what is a binary weighted register digital to analog converter? It utilizes a summing operational amplifier circuit. And binary weighted registers are used to distinguish each bit from the MSB, that is most significant bit, to the LSB, that is least significant bit. And transistors are used as a switch between reference voltage and ground. Bit high or low, how that is, we will be seeing. So, the binary weighted register circuit will be looking like this. Okay, so here, this is operational amplifier, which is used here, which is a summing op amp. You can see here number of resistors are connected in the circuit and there are again different switches are connected here. So, how it's going to work? We are having a reference voltage given to each resistor and again through switch the same line is connected with ground and switches that you can see here from switch S0 to switch SN-1, all these switches will be working on these bits. Okay, so B0 is my least significant bit and BN-1 is my most significant bit. So, we are going to provide our digital code here by using these bits, or rather the digital value is provided to these switches accordingly the switch will act and it will be decided whether to connect reference voltage or ground with this resistance or with this line of voltage. So if the bit is high, the switch will connect the line to reference voltage, and if the bit is low, then the switch will connect this line to the ground. So let's understand here what is happening. If the bit is high means if the value at this point is 1, this switch will connect this line of voltage with through resistance will connect to Vref. So Vref will pass through the circuit. And if the bit is 0, that is low, the switch will connect this line to ground, means voltage available in that line will be 0 as ground is 0 volt condition. So let's understand here, the digital signal which we need to convert to analog form will be provided by using these bits, and which will act as a switch between reference voltage and ground. Okay, so when the bit is high, the reference voltage will be flowing through the circuit, and this part is again a summing operational amplifier. Here the feedback resistor RF is given, which is again equal to the value of resistor R, and here you can see the in each line there is a resistor available, but the values will be R, then 2R, then 4R, then 8R. Likewise, if we are having n number of bits, so we need to go for n minus 1 number of switches, and 2 power n minus 1 into R resistors values. You can see here why it is called as a binary weighted resistor. The resistors are in increasing value of 2 power n. So here it is 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, likewise 2 power n minus 1. So such n number of resistors we need to use, which are again having the weightage of binary 2 power n values. Okay, so each time the resistor will get incremented by 1 power of 2. So R, 2R, 4R, 8R, 16R, 32R, likewise. So how many number of bits are there to be converted? Those number of resistors is to be added in the circuit of a summing operational amplifier. So here again the total current will flow through the circuit, and particularly we are using a feedback resistor which is having value same as the resistor which is used in the circuit, and voltages V1, V2, V3, V4, likewise up to Vn will be flowing through each line. Okay, so this is regarding S is for switch here. So it is S0, Sn-4, Sn-3, Sn-2, Sn-1. So how it's going to work, we will be going through, and we will get V out of a summing op amp. We know output voltage from a summing op amp formula, we know. So here again voltages V1 to Vn are connected to either Vref if corresponding bit is high, we have already seen that, or ground if corresponding bit is low. So Vref or ground will be chosen by a switch according to the bit. If bit is high, Vref is chosen. If bit is low, then ground is chosen. Okay, and Bn-1 is the most significant bit, and B0 is the least significant bit, that we have already seen. Output voltage of op amp is given by following formula. We know V out is equal to minus, as the input is connected to inverting end of an operational amplifier, we will get a negative sign which says the output is 180 degree out of phase with input. That is the only case. And RF into V1 by R plus V2 by 2R plus V3 by 4R plus so on and so forth, Vn divided by 2 power n minus 1 into R. This will be the formula for the output of a summing operational amplifier. Keep in mind, it is a summing operational amplifier. So it will give Vout using this formula. So Vout is nothing but analog output voltage which is needed from a D2A converter. Resolution of again D2A converter is given by VLSB, that is VREP divided by 2 power n, where n is again number of bits. Okay, so we know that we are going to choose the feedback resistor which is equal to a resistor in the circuit. So if we choose RF is equal to R, Vout is going to become again a negative of the value of V1 plus V2 by 2 plus V3 by 4 plus so on plus Vn divided by 2 power n minus 1 will be the formula. Okay, again V1 to Vn are all V reference. So again we can convert this formula in terms of Vout is equal to minus V rep into V1 plus V2 by 2 plus V3 by 4 plus and so on plus Vn by 2 power n minus 1. Okay, and if we consider only example of 4 bit converter, then it will become like this. Here we are going to show bits. Okay, so for again if you go to the diagram, see if we need to go for 4 bit only. So my 4 bit will be, see here, this is my most significant bit. So n is 4 now, so it will become B 4 minus 1, that is 3. So it is B3 S3, B2 S2, B1 S1, B0 S0. So this will be the 4 resistors which are connected in the circuit. So for MSB B3 we are having R, then for B2 we are having 2R, B1 we are having 4R, and B0 we are having 8R. Okay, so value of resistor is increasing with the power of 2, and here we are having 4 bits from B0 to B4, and again switches S0 to S3, sorry, B0 to B3 and S0 to S3 are the switches. So what is going to happen now? Only which bits are high, that on those switches only pass the reference voltage through the circuit. So let's go through one example here. So this will be the condition. In terms of bits, Vout will be equal to minus Vref into B3 plus B2 by 2 plus B1 by 4 plus B0 by 8 will be the condition now. Okay, what we have done in this formula is we have taken V1 is equal to V2 is equal to Vt is equal to up to Vn. We are having the same voltage which is Vref. So we have taken that common out and we have given the weightage of bits to each and every fraction here. So formula for 4 bit will become like this, where B3 corresponds to bit 3 and B2 corresponds to bit 2. Okay, and likewise B0 is for bit 0. Here B3 is most significant bit and B0 is least significant bit. So suppose we need to convert a value of some digital 4 bit input voltage, which may be let's say 1010. Okay, 1010 means B3 is 1, B2 is 0, B1 is 1 and B0 is 0. Then what will happen? Say reference voltage we need to take here. Say we have taken 8 volts as a reference voltage here, so we are going to supply 8 volt as a reference voltage, and we need to convert the digital value 1010 in analog signal. Then what happens? So B3 will be 1. So how the Vout formula is going to change? So Vout formula will become Vout is equal to my reference voltage is 8. So minus 8 into bracket B3 is 1, then plus B2 is 0 as it is low, so 0 into half, plus B1 is again 1, so B1 into 1 by 4, plus B0 is again 0 into 1 by 8. So basically what we are going to get here is minus 8 into 1 plus 1 by 4. So which is again 8 into 5 by 4. Okay, minus 8 into 5 by 4, which is again minus 10 volts. Okay, so V out which we are going to get here will be minus 10 volts. Keep in mind, so 1010 is nothing but a binary representation of a 10 value. We know that. So exactly we are going to get 10 volts at output of summing op amp. If we are going to take next any example, say the value of binary digital input is 1001, that is the B3 is 1 and B0 is 1, then what's going to the output? Minus 8 into B3 is 1 plus B0 is 1, that is 1 by 8. So it will be minus 8 into 9 by 8, which is again minus 9 volts. So we know 1001 is the representation of binary representation of a 9 decimal value. So we have get the output as minus 9 volts. We know negative sign is just because the output is 180 degree out of phase with input, that's why the negative sign is there. So now here we can see how the digital value of a signal is converted to a analog signal by using a reference voltage here. Okay, I hope you have understood the conversion of digital signal into an analog signal by using a binary weighted register DAC. Okay, now we will go through advantages of binary weighted register D2A converter. So basically there are two main advantages: the simple construction, simple for construction analysis, and faster conversion. These are two main advantages of binary weighted register D2A converter. And then let's go to the disadvantages. Now disadvantage, main disadvantage is for higher number of, for higher resolution definitely we need to go for higher number of bits. As we have already gone through the formula of resolution, it is V ray divided by 2 power n. So whatever is the value of n, that number of value, if it is high, the resolution is also high and accuracy also high. So it requires large number of ranges of resistors. See, 2000 as to 1 for 12 bit DAC with necessary high precision for low resistors. Means we need to go for weighted resistors to R, from R towards we, for 12 bit C it will be 2 power 12, which is a very large number, that is 2000 resistors will be required. Again, we need to precisely control the value of each resistor, which is again the power addition of power of 2 for every resistor. So from R to 2R, 4R, 8R, likewise up to 2 power 12 R's to be chosen, and each resistor is precisely chosen. So the lower resistors need to have very accurate value. Okay, which is again a tedious task. Choosing the resistors will be tedious task, because the there will be definitely tolerance of each resistor. So there is a problem with choosing of resistor, and such a large number of resistors are to be chosen with precise values. So there comes error in the measurement. Okay, and again it requires low switch resistance in transistors. So there must not be any resistance by switches. As the bits are given to the switches readily, the transistors must act accordingly and choose between the VRF and ground very quickly, so that there will not be any delay. And obviously it needs large number of components for higher bit converters, so it can be expensive, as we need to choose precise value of resistors. So we cannot go for higher resolution here. So there we usually it is limited up to 8 bits. Okay, that is, these are the main disadvantages of binary weighted registers. Okay, so in next video we will go through the next type, that is R2R ladder DAC, which is again advantages or superior over this binary weighted register. How, that will take in next class. Thank you.